The Mandalorian show has really given us some great droid appearances. What's up, Meta Nerds? This video will of course have spoilers for episode 6 of The Mandalorian, so if you haven't got there yet, just leave a like and come back later. There's way too many cool moments in this one to spoil. But if you're ready, let's talk about the two new droids used by the New Republic. They don't have names yet, so we'll simply call this humanoid one the Type 1, and the astromech-looking droid the Type 2. Both were used by the New Republic as prisoner guards in this prison transport ship. Let's start with the Type 1.
Intruder alert! Open fire!
It seems to have been built off of a similar frame to the KX-series droids used by the Galactic Empire, with K2SO being the most noteworthy of this line. This belt most likely had battery packs or Tabana gas, both of which are the ammunition for blasters. Speaking of which, the main weapon is the DH-17 blaster pistol, which was great for use inside of ships. We have a really old video that compares it to a submachine gun, as it was below the power of a rifle, but was still powerful enough for a military role, and compact enough for those tight, close-quarter combat scenarios once a ship was boarded. It could even be fired fully automatic, but this would drain the power packs in 20 seconds, so that may be why we see so much ammo on the belt. And then there's what very well may be a thermal detonator, or something similar. But they most likely have a very strict protocol not to ever use this weapon inside of the ship, unless things got really desperate and were given the order by an organic superior. This droid's whole body was covered in strong, blaster-resistant material that can take holdout blaster bolts without breaking its stride. But a vibroblade in the right hands could slice through the weak points of the joints, and even pierce some of the armor plating. And we also see that the head is a weak spot. At close range, the DH-17 leaves an enormous hole. But even the smaller blaster pistols repeatedly barraging the head casing could also break through. And while we're looking at the head, you can see this round access port and large maintenance panel. This is pretty standard on everything from combat to protocol droids, and would be used to upgrade software or even perform memory wipes. This area also had the attachments so that it could hold the backup weapon. The antenna would receive instructions from a command center, but also coordinate with the other droids. Something that is always an advantage in droid fighters, where they always know each other's positions, and can coordinate with an efficiency that would best even telepathic organic combatants. This yellow sensor array could most likely pick up on a larger portion of the electromagnetic spectrum than most meatbags. And we see that they're more intelligent than the lower level combat droids like the B1. With this unit that lost its leg, it just leans on the wall and continues fighting. They're not as agile as the commando droids used by the CIS, but their tenacity and hand-to-hand combat skills are quite impressive. The flames used by the Mandalorian were able to melt some of the wiring and circuitry when it was brought in close, but at a distance we really don't see that much damage. Really, this move works to just break the incoming fire, as these flames would temporarily blind the sensor array, setting it up for the following attack. Then we can see the hydraulic fluid spouting from the limbs once they're separated, and since they're prison guards, their digits could extend a sort of key for the cells. This is similar to the kind used by astromechs like R2-D2, and speaking of the R-series, the New Republic Type 2 droid definitely seems to be an R1-series variant. We first saw these in Watto's workshop, and one was being sold by the Jawas. In fact, there was even a Jawa variant that was modified to help around the shop. This droid was made by Industrial Automaton, who would make all of the rest of the R-series astromechs. And it was actually this unit that made the single hyperspace jump standard in some areas. They were always found on capital ships and freighters, but the original was not armed. It was also slow and ran on a track, not the quickly moving repulsor system in these new guards. I would speculate that this protrusion was changed to be at least a medium blaster, something good enough to overwhelm personal energy shields, used by both organics or droids like the Droideka. Maybe it was even strong enough to punch a hole through Beskar. It had a great weight to it, so when Berg is able to throw it around so easily, it really shows off the incredible strength of the Deveronian species. Their biology was one of the most odd of all Star Wars species. As humans have iron in their blood, this devilish species needs silver for blood production. They are described as having incredibly dense bones and muscles, and weigh much more than a similarly sized human. We don't see Berg puffing on that yellow, but a common thing with Deveronians is that they would smoke sulfur. Inhaling it rapidly went into the bloodstream and greatly increased their speed and strength. And so that's it for the New Republic security droids. And there was a mouse droid too, we can't forget that, but I hope this is just the first of many more new droids to come. But let me know what you thought about them in the comments down below. The only cool thing I want to point out is that the concept art shows that these droids looked a lot different, way more bulky, and just probably didn't work for those fight scenes. And I want to point out that the fact that these were droid guards adds to how outraged the Mandalorian would be at being locked up. Imagine being powerless in a cell under the control of droids, when it was droids that destroyed your town and killed your parents. Just a cool touch there. If you want to connect with us on social media, find ways that you can help support this channel without it costing you a thing, or check out our Patreon. Be sure to check out the links in the description. Special shout out to our supporters over on Patreon, but most important of all, remember, don't smoke sulfur, and the Force will be with you. Always.